إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما صدق الله العظيم أما بعد all praises are due to Allah we thank him we praise him we believe in him and we testify that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah alone and that Muhammad is his handpicked messenger may the peace mercy and blessing of Allah be upon Rasulullah his family and whoever follows them towards righteousness until the day of Qiyamah. Amma ba'd, ibadallah. Today's khutbah is about a topic that is the key to every successful achievement on the face of this earth. And again, is the key to success in the life hereafter, which is none other than being together, unity. Teben kambengo, benno. Is the key to every success in this life and the life hereafter. And besides, unity is not even an option. It is an obligation. It is obligatory upon every Muslim to love his Muslim brother without an excuse. And Allah made it very clear in different parts of the Quran. In Surah Ma'idah, Allah said, and hold fast altogether by the robe of Allah. and be not divided among yourselves. And remember with gratitude Allah's favor on you. Remember the favor of Allah upon you. For you were enemies and He joined your hearts in love so that by His grace you became brothers. And you were on the brink of the pit of Jahannam. You were almost entering into hell and Allah Azza wa Jalla saved you from there. This is how Allah makes His signs clear to you that you may be guided. So being together, unity is not an option, it's an obligation. Allah said, وَعَتَسِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Hold fast to the rope of Allah and do not get divided. Again, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in his farewell sermon, part of the message was, all mankind is from Adam and Eve. An Arab has no superiority over a non-Arab. A non-Arab has no superiority over an Arab. A white man has no superiority over a black man, nor has a black man any superiority over the white except by piety and good action. Learn that every Muslim is a brother to his Muslim brother, and that the Muslims constitute one brotherhood. Innamal mu'minuna ikhwa. In another narration, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that a Muslim is the brother of another Muslim. He does not oppress him, nor does he leave him at the mercy of others. This is narrated in Sahih Muslim. The Muslim is your brother. You don't oppress him. You don't leave him on the mercy of others. أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. Again, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, none of you will have iman, none of you will be a true believer until he wishes for himself or for his brother what he likes for himself. لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. يمين كانوا يفعل إلى الإيمان يا ولا إلى الإسلام أو أتتم ملا فدرون يمين كانوا يفعل أيك كوتي يمين كانوا يبادينه. Ken dinem wala islamam dumut ludut lim ene bopam rek mu ene ko mbokki julitam ci lu wer nak. Again, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a narration, by the one in whose hand is my soul, meaning I swear to Allah, walladhi nafsi biyadi, by the one in whose hand is my soul, you will not enter Jannah until you believe, and you will not believe until you love one another. This is in Bukhari, volume 5. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam kila yekali akalte dunna al janna fodrong nal danken ya tamari man satallal nin danken ya dun atina fodrong al yenyo kanu ken du duga al janna ludud mu am gombu mu sek way do am gom ludud gen sopante. In another narration, he even further went on to say, can I tell you something that will bring in love and peace among you? Then the Sahabi said, ya Rasulallah, please go ahead. He said, spread salam among yourself. Al-salam rota alia janjang alia siyandi al-dam maltema. Unfortunately, when I meet with my brother today, many a times people will wait for them to be greeted before them initiating the greeting. Fangwaro kamma. Afela binajan, bajibe la faabem konton nale. Name konto ita konton. And the Prophet said, do you want, can I tell you what will bring that among you? Spread salam. Don't wait for your brother to say assalamu alaikum. He might have forgotten. And shaitan might say to you, you know what? It was intentional. He didn't want to say salam. And arrogance can overtake you. And in return, you won't say salam. The next day you guys meet, you will be parted altogether. And until that happens sometimes to such a degree that these two guys would die and meet Allah without reconciliation. Notwithstanding the fact that every Thursday their deeds were suspended just by that foolish action. Anyantan konton na atele nyanta folota, atele folo nyantan konton na man konton ta konton. Moma warona nje ken nuyu, nongo ma nuyu, duma kon nuyu. Legi dene nje ken nuyu wot samorom, nyufar tongo chi, chilu nyaka fayda, arhames buneke chi jif jubahi didem chi yalla, nyun sing bos du aga. Luka fijar. Abu Hurairata radiallahu anhu narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that verily Allah the Exalted is pleased with you by three things, and He is displeased by three things. He is pleased for you to worship Him without associating partners with Him, and to hold fast to the rope of Allah. وَأَتَسِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا, and not to become divided. And He is pleased for you
to gossip one. So he is displeased for you when you gossip one another. Su de yalla amna liko merlo wala su de yalla dina la soril yermandem liko waral moy so nekke di jow sa mbokki julit wala kenen ku dut mom sa minka alala kamfa jindi mokal wolam ko nalbe siring albe molukoma kumala. He is displeased for you to gossip one another and to ask many unnecessary questions. Sometimes people will ask questions that are not necessary. Even the Allah Azza wa Jalla said that stop asking questions which when revealed to you would cause you harm. When Allah says do this, sami'na wa ata'na. Sami'na wa ata'na. We have heard and we will obey. Sami'na wa ata'na. Sam'an wa ta'a. We have heard na mwelem ba baral. Na bota alalaya. If the Prophet says do this, we have heard and we will obey because it's from Rasulullah. He does not talk according to his desire. وَمَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. He does not talk according to his desire. Anytime he decided to speak, it was an inspiration from Allah. And besides, Allah said in the Quran, وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُ. كِيلَا نِمْ فَمَفَنْ نَاتَالْكَنْ دُرَنْ أَلَاتَ أَيَا الْفَتَنْدِ مِنَّا الْوَتُجِي أَسْوَنَيَاتَ. Do not add, delete or change. Don't make any adjustment. Al-yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'amati wa raditu lakum al-islam dina. That has been completed 1400 years ago. So there are no regrets in following Allah Azza wa Jalla's command according to the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he said, stop us. Allah Azza wa Jalla is displeased with an individual who asks unnecessary questions and the one who wastes his wealth. This wealth is a trust. Ning alayete ke banata e doke fuaroti. It is part of waste to spend something, your wealth in something that's haram. Or spend your wealth in something that's not necessary. Eat as much as you can as far as necessity is concerned. Drink as much as you can. Live a comfortable life. Kulu washrabu wala tusrifu. Eat and drink. But do not waste. Is a privilege. It should not be abused. Whatever you have, someone better than you in status, as far as iman is concerned, is deprived. You have a lot of money, and your connection with Allah is very poor. There is someone who is Allah's friend, and he is starving. So do not waste. Anytime you decide to spend, let it be in a just cause, that which is pleasing to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Abdullah bin Umar reported that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, those who are merciful will be shown mercy by the most merciful. Be merciful to those on earth and the one in the heavens will have mercy on you. Mulmini ya lonko ikabalafa tandi molla, ikabalafa molye, ikabalafa dafengolye. Mimbe sangoto minna balafa warata beti mimmu mariman satallati abala balafa jindile kanne. Be merciful to those on earth. Balafa moliye minibe banko kan minibe santo la balafa se jikan jumala be santo ala damala fa be jila la ya nati abe malaikol kila ya nati indirectly wala directly. Yentibi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mune kep ki nga xamne wonenga yermande yermande dina wacce sa kaw joge ci kan yalla subhanahu wa ta'ala mu nek ñi nek ci suuf moy doomi adamay ñu ni neena fi nek de même rabbi sax yentibi sallallahu alayhi wasallam mu ne ñu nek ci suuf bo len wonante yermande ñi ci kaw dinañ wacce yermande bu yermante ci kaw suuf rek yalla yermandem dina wacce suñu kaw. But for a variety of reasons, ibadallah, we appear to be fragmented and disconnected from each other. Considering what Allah said about unity, considering the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about unity, we are still divided. The Quran urges Muslims to be open-hearted and to respect minor differences of opinion. It also warns us to the grave dangers of disunity and mutual hatred. Although our numbers increase by the day, during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you have less than 1 million Muslim. Today we have over 1.4 billion. But the disunity is increasing by the day. Today we are divided into dozens and into nations. into tribe. The divisions within ourselves is becoming greater. We have further divisions of mutual, hostile, and exclusive groups. A group that is showing hostility to another one without any reason. A tribe sowing hostility to another one without justification. We have a rather fragmented and disunited ummah. We can sugarcoat it anyhow we like. This is the fact. An ummah that often seems to be at odds within itself. We can start to put things together by coming together, by uniting under one banner. Inna hadhihi ummatukum ummatan wahida wa ana rabbukum fa'budun. This ummah and brotherhood of yours is one, and I'm your Lord, be servitude to me. The principle of tawheed underpins the great diversity of all created things. Within every species, there is tremendous variety. In nature, differences. In nature, differences are not a sign of weakness. We are different, so we are weak. He is white and black, so that's a weakness? No. He belongs to this tribe and I belong to this one, that's a weakness? No. He lives in this country and I live in that one? No. He is this and I am this. So our differences is not a sign of weakness, but a celebration of the creativity of Allah. Our differences, different colors, different species, different language, different in everything, is a celebration of the fact that Allah is the most creative Lord ever. Azza wa Jalla. He has power to do whatever it likes in different forms, in different formats, in different colors, in different stages, at different levels, to show how creative he is. This is something for us to admire and enjoy with a sense of wonder and excitement. The variety and diversity we find in the ozone, the variety and diversity we find on land, the variety and diversity we find even in the air, the different atmospheric levels, are also apparent in our human behavior. We must not see our human differences as a cause. Rather, it is a blessing. Each and every one of us has gathered a wealth of experience from different geographical backgrounds. From Gambia to China, from Saudi Arabia to India, from different social and cultural influences. When we all share our experience freely, there is a collective enrichment for everyone. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. أما بعد عباد الله, unity does not mean uniformity. We do not have to look the same to get to be united. We don't have to speak the same language to be united. We don't have to dress the same way to be united. We don't have to share each and every opinion unanimously to be united. But we can still be united under these differences. In Surah Hujurat, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, O mankind, we created you from a single pair of a male and a female and made you into nations and tribes that you may know each other. Verily, the most honorable or the most honored of you in the sight of Allah is the one most righteous of you. He's the most honorable in the sight of Allah. And Allah has full knowledge and is well acquainted of all the things that you do. Ya ayyuhan nas, inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha, wa ja'alnakum su'uban wa kaba'ila lita'arafu, inna akramakum indallahi atqakum. Forget about the differences. Forget about our worldly status. Forget about how much we are worth as far as material wealth is concerned. Allah said, that's not my priority. That's for the help purpose of recognition, for you to recognize each other. The most important thing is for you to be conscious of Allah. If you are the most conscious, then you are my friend. If you are the most conscious, you're closer to me. If you are the most conscious, you're successful, or you will be successful in this life and the life hereafter. If one is conscious of Allah, unity becomes his priority. Momo silata mari man satallala. Mota kawandila kamam teben kambeng alakua. Alke kilinti, al nyokanu, ni silata alala. Na afika ya tije, amanjari mwoye wafoye. Kep kuragal yalla, kendula ware purungen neka benda. Nick, it's not an option, it's an obligation. This verse doesn't say, oh Muslims. He said, ya ayyuhan nas, oh mankind. It doesn't say, oh Muslims. He said, oh you who believe. He doesn't even say, oh you who believe. Ya ayyuhal ladina amanu, oh Muslims. He said, ya ayyuhan nas, oh mankind. This verse addresses every human being. This verse emphasizes the essential unity of the human species, the essential unity of the human race. Islam is inclusive, not exclusive. When we show respect to others, we also show courtesy to Allah Azza wa Jalla. There are two kinds of unity which we must try to understand and distinguish clearly. Unity is of two types. There is unity of purpose and unity of opinion. As Muslims, we should always be united in one purpose. And that purpose is for the unite under the purpose for which we are created. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنْسِ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I've not created you for any other purpose. For any other purpose, but that you should serve me. So we should unite under this banner. Why are we here? To serve Allah. So there should be a unity of purpose. What is it? That is to earn the pleasure of Allah. However, we might differ in our opinions in reaching out to that purpose. That shouldn't be a problem. So that means seeking to please Allah. But we must not distress by minor differences of opinion. It is humanly impossible to always have unity of opinion. Kambelo. Nte sontale, ite sontale, ite sontale, ite sontale. Nte la miro ye nyine dina. Ifana na miro ye nyine dila. Nyindonga la miro ye wala diala. So mbebe kambena na miro tolo. That is impossible. Suma halat ak sa halat ak halati kene. Nyeb munta boka neka bena. Way jublu way bi munna neka bena. Yalla ni tahajok. Te kontante yalla angiru mandem la nyosaku. Kere kero wale kumayata, mine atina mbende benna nganyo dila. Mine atina mbende idea dila. Because kere kero mimba akoma. Purka mariman satallala dunyo njinije. Watonte la miro ni itaja fatano. Bari nina kere kero keta kilinti mbese kisa dunia jankatafo ya umalqia. So as long as we keep our purpose clearly in view, there can be many opinions as to the best way of achieving our goal. By mutual consultation, sharing our knowledge and experience, we can move forward. If we must disagree on some matter, then let us remember the right way to disagree. There is no problem to disagree, but let it be constructive. Even if you have to criticize, let it be a constructive criticism. And when you are in a debate, use the right target. You need to debate. It's very important. I read in a book that it is part of being successful in life, in whatever you do, that your critic should be an intelligent person. If you want to be successful in life, whatever you do, if at all you have someone who criticizes you constructively, he should be intelligent. Then you can uplift yourself. Nilafta kisala. Momo ye kusoto purke ya mari. Ila baro to be minna wanyanta kela moti miya lonka hakilo diata hakilo melunta bari mo miya lonko to lela ala nafa man wara. So it's part of being successful in life that whoever criticizes you should be intelligent, and you need to appreciate that, take that on board, so long as it's constructive. If it's not, just see what works for you and deal with it. So if we must disagree on some matter, let us remember the right way to disagree. In a Muslim, in a debate, this should be the attitude of the Muslim. Start by saying, I think I am right, but I could be wrong, you know. I'm debating someone. It doesn't matter how much hatred I have for him, even though there is no justification to hatred. But if you're debating him, say to yourself, before anything else, I think I am right, but I may be wrong, you know. And I think he is wrong, but he could be right, you know. I want to win. I want to be the winner. But have at the back of your mind, say to yourself, I think I am right, but you know, I'm not perfect. I could be wrong. And give the same to him. I think he is wrong, but he could be right. That would actually rid you of arrogance. What be waro from Abondilan? Because there is someone who is not concerned about how successful this debate is or what we can add from it. The fact of the matter is, he wants everyone to say, MashaAllah, and your lona mantara keri. Look, he has overpowered him in the debate. What for? I don't want to humiliate him. I just want to put my point across. But we have to be together and enjoy whatever the outcome it is. Bi-idhnillahi azza wa jalla. So by mutual consultation, sharing our knowledge and experience, we can move forward. If we must disagree, let it be in the best of way. If we keep this attitude of humanity in all our dealings with one another, no one risks humiliation, motemalla, or hurting the feelings of any other person in a disagreement. We can debate and disagree in the most agreeable manner, where we always maintain mutual respect, dignity. These are the building blocks for a real lasting unity. Inshallah, in our next khutbah, we will continue with the importance of unity and more so what we can do in order to unite every day, always, until we meet Allah Azza wa Jalla. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت وقنا واشرف عنا شر ما قضيت فإنك تقضي ولا يقضى عليك إنه لا يذل من واليت ولا يعز من عاديت تباركت ربنا وتعاليت نستغفرك من كل ذنب ونتوب إليك ونؤمن بك ونتوكل عليك ونثني عليك الخير كله يا من يجير ولا يجار عليه أجرنا من النار ومن خزي النار ومن كل عمل يقربنا إلى النار ودخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا جبار إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون وأقيم الصلاة